This is actually a little paper calculator that I made. You follow a tube, they split off. These tubes are directional. Your first choice is whether you want to choose 0 or 1. Which would you like to choose?
Let's choose 0.
0. So you choose 0. That leads to this this instruction to flip. You flip the page, continue down, plus you don't choose the operator. But you do choose the next number that you want to add to 0.
1. Let's do 0 plus 1.
0 plus 1. Go here. Then you just follow the tubes. This is all done automatically. You follow down, down, down. 0 plus 1 is 1. That's your answer. 0, 1 is the answer.
Let's do 0 plus 0.
0 plus 0. Okay. Mm. So you start here. You choose 0. This tells you to flip. So there's your 0. Let's choose to add another 0. So we'll flip again. So you'll notice when you flip these flaps, they can either connect or block off certain pathways later on. So that's basically how it all works. You follow these paths. When you get to here, it says to flip. And then you get to the end.
No, so answer.
Your answer is 0, 0.
All right, let's do 1 plus 1, Jason.
Okay, I've always wanted to know what that is. It's a good thing I have this calculator here. I'll go ahead and choose this 1. Leads me to 1. Add another 1. That goes to the equal sign. It tells me to flip. It tells me to flip again. And there's our answer. 1, 0. Or 2 in binary. This is basically how calculators and computers work, you know, electronic versions of these mazes.
If you'd like to know why on earth Jason was making a calculator out of paper, you really need to see what came before and what's coming next. Have a look at these extra videos that we're putting on Numberphile either right now or very soon.